Okay.
I'm Cabot Finch, public relations and crisis management, and I'm here to help you. You'll start by building a Hammond creation lab. We've already started on...
Fix those settings. There we go.
I'm an enclosure for you. You should just attach it to the side. But watch out for dinosaurs. Just kidding. Let's focus on what you're here to do, which is create dinosaur facilities on the islands we call the Five Deaths. Actually, Las Cinco Muertes, because Spanish is the lingo of choice around here. You'll need to connect it to the pre-existing network of paths and the power grid.
Oh, that's what I was after.
Now comes the real test, incubating a dinosaur. You'll start with a Struthiomimus. Select the creation lab and pick a hatchery bay. There's enough genome data for your first viable dinosaur.
The machinations of the ambitious, undoing extinction, playing with nature's laws. What can possibly go wrong?
Come on, Doctor. You know we've learned so much, and invested even more in our Jurassic operations since the last time.
Yes, Mr. Finch, yes, the last time. There's always a last time. And a next.
Yeah.
Begins the most precious moment, the result of incalculable actions and reactions, trials and errors, genetic mutations and unknowable combinations, chaos, all leading to a living, breathing, thinking being, an entity, distinct and unique. And now we, you, just manufacture them. So, well done, I guess.
I mean, you have to say, it is interesting technology. Okay, so now what do I do?
The Hammond Foundation has three main areas of interest. Security, entertainment, and science. I've already nudged the heads of each division to reach out to you personally. They'll offer opportunities and incentives for you to be part of their team. Choose one of their contracts. It'll help you develop your facility.
Hey, I'm Isaac. I've been hearing good things about you. I'm in charge of the entertainment division here. What good is the world's greatest show if no one sees it? Don't answer. That's rhetorical and painfully obvious. What I'm saying is that we need people in our parks. Fill up our facilities with warm bodies. Numbers bring revenue, excitement, and opportunities.
Okay.
Contracts can be requested from the division heads inside the control room. Complete these to increase your reputation and gain additional revenue to keep expanding your park. So, one more thing. Your reputation. Your rep, quote-unquote. Keep an eye on it, okay? If you have a solid reputation with a division, you're more likely to benefit from them. Financially, I mean. But, like life, it's a balancing act. Each division is vying for your attention, and if they don't get it, they tend to take it personally.
Well, we don't want them to take, we especially don't want security to take it personally. We need to have a secure park.
The entertainment division is taking notice of your success. As your reputation increases with them, so too does the opportunity to tackle more challenging missions.
I'm Claire Deering, and I've been on these islands before. On Isla Nublar, I made some mistakes, and I've tried to set them right. I believe in what we're doing, and I believe in these dinosaurs.
Hey, it's Isaac. How you doing? I got some cool stuff you need to be a part of, so I'm putting it out there. Come on and help the winning team. Mine. All right, look, I am all about the show. With these dinosaurs, we have one unlike any other on the planet. Theme parks rely on drawing people in. And what is more attractive than new dinosaurs? Well, me, of course. Yeah, no, what I'm saying is let's get some fresh dinos in the hopper.
Good! Your first expedition team is out. They'll bring back what they find to the Fossil Center for extraction.
Okay, let's see what this is.
Your job is simple, really. Create dinosaurs which attract visitors to your facilities, brings in capital, money, huh? Which means you can do more research to build better facilities and create more dinosaurs, and there you go. A circle of life, development and resources, nature and commerce. See? Simple.
Small power station, research. Well, what should we do next for our little...
This is Lambert, head of security.
Yours, theirs, and mine. Welcome to the islands. So here's our basic conundrum. We want to keep our animals under control while simultaneously encouraging instinctive behaviors, because these animals have potential as combatants. Look, everyone's fear object, myself included, is to have these animals running free and loose in the park. But we can't exploit them globally without taking some chances.
You should extract genomes from fossils that have been collected inside your fossil center. That will increase the amount of viable data you have to create dinosaurs.
Let's see, let's... Building upgrades.
Security isn't always clean or easy, but it is always necessary. So look this contract over.
Okay, so closures.
So, you've got dinosaurs your guests want to get up close and personal with? The thing is, they can't. Construct facilities to increase visibility and keep visitors the right side of the safety glass.
It's the dinosaur you can't see that's going to be the problem. Your new viewing galleries help in that regard. So well done on completing that contract.
Lifespan. Oh, we can do that. We can do that pretty easily, I think.
I don't know what's worse, treating these creatures like grist for the mill or propping them up as curiosities.
When another contract comes up, I'm turning to you first. Lambert here. I've got a new assignment that I think is perfect for your skill set. Give it a once over, then let me know if you're interested.
Yeah, okay.
Glad to have you on board. As you can imagine, the animals in the various facilities are constantly probing for weaknesses in our security systems. They're smarter and more devious than people give them credit for. But I refuse to underestimate their capabilities. That's why I'm always testing and evaluating our security protocols and barriers. And this is where you come in.
I've got to give this guy Lambert his due. He actually sees these animals as both opportunity and threat.
Yeah.
I'm gonna need you to extract enough DNA from fossils to incubate and hatch a dinosaur. This is the first phase of this mission. Carry on.
Dr. Dua, this is our new Director of Operations.
I'm aware, Cabot. I'm Dr. Dua. I run the science division of our operation. Okay, you're going to need to build your reputation in the science division. Not easy with me around, but you'll manage. That means managing our dinosaur population and seeing that they are flourishing.
Well, there we go. That looks big and nasty and...
Carnivore, I see. This time, a ceratosaurus. There are distinctive spines that run down its back, and a bladed horn on its head. Just what you don't want to run into when you're out there alone. Or in a group.
Thank you.
and now we reach the inevitable. Life begets death. But here's the question that you gotta ask yourself. Was this avoidable? The answer? Of course not. Death, it's always coming. But could you have delayed it? Well, that's maybe another story.
This opportunity is too good to miss, so don't.
Like us, different dinosaurs require different diets. Make sure to place the correct type of feeder in an enclosure. I'm a red meat man myself.
And then...
Okay, next you'll need to incubate the animal in a Hammond Creation laboratory before releasing and housing it in an enclosure. You'll also want to make sure we've got an ACU presence on this island.
It looks like you've run out of power. That's not good. Build more power stations or increase your output.
I'm Owen Grady, Owen to my friends. I've seen things I'd rather not talk about, but it hasn't dampened my commitment to the dinosaurs. The raptors more generally, and me and Blue specifically. We have a special relationship, like what I have with Claire. Less complicated. Anyway, nice to meet you.
Reminding what I really got at the moment. Thank you. too expensive at the moment. I need money, so I just gotta sit here and wait for a few moments. Oh, good, I was worried he was dead. It's good to see that he's still around.
Contracts help with research. Research is the foundation on which the Jurassic World properties are built. And oh, look, what have we here? A contract.
We'll do that contract, most definitely.
Everybody says you can handle yourself, so this new contract should be a cakewalk, right?
Research Center, new research buildings, building upgrade. So I need 100,000 for that. Okay. I also need to know another expedition. What a great new expedition center it looks like for the one.
Just heard from the client and they are happy. Which means we are too. Way to go, man.
Search that. What do we need for another expedition operation? Ah, so I gotta go and unlock another island in order to do that. Okay.
Right. This next bit is gonna sound a little crazy because, frankly, it is. but we are gonna encourage one of the dinosaurs to breach our containment grid. We'll then react and see if our procedures and personnel are up to the challenge.
Yes. So at this point, I'd like to take back everything I just said about this guy.
I agree with you. But we'll do it.
The ACU, or Asset Containment Unit, should be your first port of call to bring down a rampaging dinosaur.
Okay, we have our runner. Time to tag him and bag him. We're using less than lethal, but remember, that dinosaur doesn't know this is just supposed to be a drill. So watch your back.
While I understand the need to keep our security as sharp as possible, this is not the way I would go about doing it.
You have a problem with how we keep you safe, Doctor. I'm happy to discuss it at a later time. Right now, we have our hands full.
No problem.
I give you food and you still attack and kill. You're doing a really bad job of...
You'll need to call in the offshore transport team to safely move this dinosaur back to its enclosure.
Heading to collect the asset.
Our existence is the constant evaluation of threats and opportunities. And this looks like a good opportunity.
Asset has been collected.
I need to do something about him.
Transportation underway. Transportation complete.
Mm-hmm.
true and square. Look, the thing is, we're still learning where our boundaries are when it comes to keeping these animals under control. God knows they're working out ways to exploit our weaknesses. Guess we'll find out who gets to the limits of our abilities first, us or them. Ever vigilant.
And that's always been the challenge of the Jurassic Industrial Complex. Exploitation versus security. The immense potential for profit and for violence.
There. I'll protect what I got. And then...
The more we see, the more we know. That contract turned out to be a good one for the security division. And you.
He's just like, come on, what's this going, what's going on over here? This looks interesting.
We have added a new viewing gallery for you to observe our magnificent creatures.
Yep, yes we have. That we have, that we have, that we have. We've had a few mistakes so far. We've lost a few. So that off. Let's see. What can we do here now?
My advice? Take this contract.
Okay. Okay, well... Let's see... What can we do? Yeah, that sounds like a good idea.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your comfort, we've increased the hotel capacity of the island.
What else? Well, let's see. What else can we do?
Storm defense stations help protect your park's structure against storm damage. Useful, huh?
Unused power 127. Between the two, that's 28. Send them off to do that thing.
Ladies and gentlemen,
I can't get above 86 at the moment. Unless maybe there's... We'll replace our two lost dinosaurs here.
Struthiomimus. Interesting. Another dinosaur that furthers the case of a direct linkage to our modern birds.
Add task.
Acknowledged. Adding task.
Yep, see, he's like, I want to eat that, but I can't get to it. What about all this water here? Okay. Well, there we go. How am I doing? Okay, what do you want me to do here? I don't understand what I was supposed to be doing there. That's one of the worst things. It's like, I don't know what you want me to do. I can only have 3 contracts at a time.
The last thing you'll want is hungry dinosaurs in your park. Use a ranger team to resupply feeders.
Let's connect the path.
Ladies and gentlemen, find the perfect gift at our new souvenir shop.
My advice? Keep your animals well fed, especially in situations like this.
Ah, food's the problem. Okay. What does an Edmontosaurus eat? Plants? Okay. So we just need a good feeder. I need more money. Always more money. More money, more money, more money. Ah. Yeah, that should work for you. There we go. There we go. That should help. Well, it should help some. See, his health is improving. We're now up into the 70s. He's like, I went over there. There's fresh food over there. That's where the good stuff is. Progress has been had. How am I doing monetarily? Well, we're up to 70,000. I got a gift shop.
Oh my gosh, you got a sick dinosaur on your hands. It's time to treat it. Or what comes next, that's gonna be on your hands as well.
Yeah, it will be. So we're dealing with it.
Dinosaurs detected.
Good. Good, good, good. Know what?
Task received. Confirming task.
We're going to move these things around. Actually, we're just going to delete that entirely. Wait, what the hell? He just got tossed. Just like, whoop. Come on, come on, come on, come on.
Collecting asset.
I see you've hatched a Triceratops. Might be cute now, but that's only gonna last for about a week.
Only gonna last for about a week? Yeah, probably. Okay, well, I think that's going to be it for this video. It went way longer than what I was wanting to do. Illusion! Thank you for watching Illusion Fox Gaming. We'll be back again soon. Till then, have a wonderful rest of your evening.